How to play Magic Arena. Well, playing Magic Arena is basically the same as playing the paper version. So, just like do that and shut your face hole. Thanks for watching Button Touchers videos. Of course, wait, what if you never played the paper version? What if your only experience with card games is Hearthstone, or maybe you played years ago, grew up, got a life, a job, and then only now are just realizing what a huge mistake that was? So, this is a video for somebody that is coming from Hearthstone or somebody that has never played Magic the Gathering. If you've already played before, this is not the video for you. It's gonna really seem patronizing. Anyways, on with the video. So the game of Magic, like all great games, is simple to play, but hard to master. The basic thing you need to understand is that you are an all-powerful wizard, capable of limitless things. You can crush even the most powerful of chumps. That's right, you are now the Chump Master, the one whom all other chumps look up to, King Chump, Bro Daddy Chumpster, Chump Zero, the chump with the pump who gets the most rump. And you must do battle with another wizard chump, winning by reducing that chump's life total from 20 to 0. In order to do that, you're gonna need to cast powerful creatures to fight for you, or use direct damage spells to take out your opponent directly. There are also other alternate win conditions, such as this one right here, that states that if you have 10 treasures, you win the game. Yeah, a real jerk maneuver. This is what we call a jerk card. Also, really fun to play and win the game with. There are several different types of spells, and each spell's type will indicate when they can be played. Creatures, sorceries, artifacts, enchantments, and planeswalkers can only be played on your turn during a main phase. With the exception of sorceries, these cards are considered permanents, as they stay on the battlefield permanently until some jerk removes them with an outside force. Non-permanent spells are ones that do something once, and then the card is removed once it has resolved. These are sorcery spells and instant spells. While sorcery spells are only castable during your main phase, instants are unique in that they can be cast on other players' turns. Instants tend to be spells like combat tricks, counter spells, or kill spells, but they can also be other things. This is one of the ways Magic Arena differs from Hearthstone, as you can cast spells on the turn of the other player, as in response to, or something like that. One of the great things about Magic is that the rule text on cards can subvert the rules of the game, making for some interesting and creative uses of cards. An example, if a card has flash, that means that you may cast that card at instant speed, meaning that this creature, which has flash, can be cast in response to an attack. And being that it has death touch, it will kill any creature that it's able to do combat damage to, effectively making this creature an instant speed kill spell. So how do you cast spells? By playing lands and tapping them for mana. There are green mana, black mana, white mana, blue mana, and red mana, and then also colorless mana. So this is another way that Magic is going to differ from a game like Hearthstone. Now, in a game like Hearthstone, you get a mana just sort of every turn. You get a power point that you can use, and then you just get another one each turn, and cards are going to say something like it casts, it's good for four, and you need four to cast it. In a game like Magic, you need to get lands. You don't just get mana each turn, you draw them in your deck, and you need to add a proportionate amount in your deck so that you can get the right amount of mana when you need it. This introduces things like being mana screwed, not getting enough mana to play the cards that you have, or being mana flooded, getting way too much mana. Why would you have something like this in the game? I mean, this is always a debate. It would sure be a lot easier if you just got a mana each turn, like in a game like Hearthstone, but it's almost like that was a problem that was introduced in the origination of the game, and the game itself has created cards that will alleviate that problem, and in that problem, we kind of love trying to solve that problem. Now, not every player, I know. For example, my roommate absolutely hates that aspect of the game because he's always getting mana screwed, and that happens in everyone's deck. It will happen. You will have the greatest of cards, you're a great player, but you're not drawing any mana. Or you're drawing all mana, and that is a huge pain in the ass. I got a deck right here. I got a clip right here that I'm probably showing you here, where I just have all mana and I'm just drawing all mana. And if you look, if you're able to look into my deck, I don't even have that much mana left. It's somehow statistically impossible that I'm drawing more mana, but I am, and it's just driving me crazy right here. As I said, you can play one land per turn, unless of course you have a card that subverts that rule, and you will draw those lands from your deck. You will see that each card has a casting cost, with mana symbols indicating that you must use a particular type of mana to cast it, and the number beside it indicates a mana that can be used of any type. Now let's have some examples here. This card here requires one blue mana and two mana of any color. And this card over here requires one red mana and one white mana. And this artifact here simply requires two mana of any color at all. So why do cards have casting costs like this? Well, if a card has one mana symbol in blue and the rest are colorless, that card is going to be easier to cast in other types of decks. So you could be able to splash blue into a blue red or something like that, and you could only need one blue mana in order to cast this spell, whereas a card like this, you're gonna need to have two blue and one colorless. That makes it a lot more difficult to cast. Means that early on you may not be able to cast this because you don't have the mana to play it. You will also notice that cards that have more of a mana symbol in their casting cost tend to be more powerful cards, or tend to have a more of a stronger theme in the color that they are in. That's why one card over here, like this blue counter spell, it counters a creature spell, but it doesn't counter all spells, whereas this card here that counters any spell has two blue and one colorless. Harder to play, stronger in the color of blue and its ability to counterspell, making it a better card, but a harder to play card. So the game is gonna look like this. You're gonna get your opening hand, you're gonna inspect it to see if you have enough lands and you can be able to play the things that are in your hand. You may choose to mulligan, or you'll play it. You'll play a land and maybe a spell and you pass your turn, your opponent does the same. You're gonna keep going. You might miss a land drop. This will happen. You just don't automatically get mana. Another difference from Hearthstone. You will eventually attack with creatures or spells. Your opponent will block or attack you. You'll use kill spells to kill their creatures, or they'll kill your creatures. And eventually one of you will reduce the other person's life total to zero, resulting in fantastic glory for the victor and shameful defeat for the loser. Where the thrill of the game comes, especially from my perspective, is from building a deck and seeing what works and what doesn't, what needs to be changed or outright scrapped. I really get a thrill from putting together cards and going out and seeing if I can win games with that. I don't think the game to me is all about win, win, win. It's about building your deck. It's about putting together an engine and seeing if that engine will actually run and seeing what needs to be tweaked. A deck that's winning, you know, every 2 out of 3 games, tweak something here, and all of a sudden you're noticing that you're winning even more games. That's where the fun comes in a game like Magic the Gathering. Sometimes it's not just about winning. Well, that's it. A super basic how to play Magic Arena video. Hopefully you're the type of person that might actually need something like this and you're watching all the way to the end. A player coming over from Hearthstone, or someone that's never played and is just getting into Magic via Magic Arena, good for you. If that's the case, I always like to see more people playing a game that I love, a game that I've been playing for 24 of its 25 years. For videos on basic deck building, touch the buttons that are on screen now. I'll have a couple up and I'll be featuring other decks that I see around, or decks, maybe a deck that I've made that seems a little egotistical, but I don't know. Maybe I'm just showing you what I've made. That's it. Thank you so much for watching. And remember, don't you ever touch my buttons. Don't ever touch my, not you, not Gary, nobody touches my buttons.